Hello, my name is Monica Kozbial, and I'm going to be talking about the use of operator precedence within Blockly. In this talk, I'll cover the role of operator precedence in code generation, then I'll talk about how to report the correct operator precedence within your code. After that, I'll talk about what sorts of things can go wrong and how to spot them, and finally, I'll talk about best practices in regards to operator precedence within generator code. You may be familiar with the term operator precedence within the context of mathematical expressions. The same concept is used in computer programming, with there just being more operators to account for. Operator precedence is what determines the grouping of terms and affects how the expression is evaluated. For example, in the expression 2 plus 3 times 5, the multiplication operator has a higher precedence, so we know the expression is evaluated by first multiplying 3 by 5 and then adding 2. Let's say we have the following Blockly blocks representing the expression 2 plus 3 times 5. However, in this example, the 2 plus 3 expression is grouped together and thus should be evaluated first before multiplying by 5. When Blockly generates the code for this block, it needs to add parentheses around 2 plus 3 in order for the expression to be evaluated correctly. Blockly uses the reported operator precedence to determine whether parentheses need to be added. Operator precedence is specified in two types of places. First, in value to code calls, which is used to get generated code for an input block. The strongest operator that could split the return code is passed in as an enum. Second, in the generator code for value blocks, the second item in the list returned by the block generator code is an enum representing the weakest operator that the final block of code could split at. Developers are responsible for accurately reporting operator precedence in these places in order for Blockly to determine whether wrapping code with parentheses is needed. Going back to the previous example, let's talk about how Blockly determines whether to add parentheses. In the code generator for the outermost math arithmetic block, value to code is called to get the first input block's code and is passed order multiplication to represent that the multiplication operator is the operator with the strongest precedence that could split the code returned by the value to code call. When value to code gets the generated code for the inner math arithmetic block, it receives the information that the addition operator is the operator with the weakest precedence that the return code could split at, through the order addition enum. Since order addition is weaker than order multiplication, the parentheses are added around the return of value to code, and the resulting output is 2 plus 3 wrapped in parentheses times 5. Each programming language generator in Blockly provides an ordered list of operator precedences in the form of enums prefixed with order. In Blockly, the value of the order operator enums have an inverse relationship with strength. A lower number is a stronger operator. Keep this in mind when you're referencing these enums to determine which to use in your block generator code. Remember that order atomic is always the strongest operator, and order none is the weakest. Historically, the reason for the operator enums having an inverse relationship with strength is due to older versions of documentation on JavaScript operator precedence which followed that rule. Another point of clarification for terminology is that a stronger operator is also the operator with a higher precedence, and a weaker operator is an operator with a lower precedence. We use these terms interchangeably within our documentation. We covered a fairly simple example with the math blocks, so I'd like to cover a few other examples to enhance understanding. In this table, the first column represents the generated code of a value block that has a single input represented as x. The second column lists the strongest operator which might split x, and would also correspond to the order you would be passing to the value to code call. The third column lists the weakest operator that could split the generated code listed in the first column, and would also be the order included in the block generator's return. Starting with the first row, with the generated code math.square root of x, the strongest operator against x is order none, because there are no operators acting on x. It's important to note when calling value to code, you're passing the max strength expected against the return code for that input, not of the entire block of code. The operators in the generated code are order member for the dot square root and order function call for the square root function call. It doesn't matter what operators are within the return of x, because if they would be weaker, then value to code would have wrapped it in parentheses and it would no longer be a place that the code could split at. Order function call is a weaker operator based on the operator precedence table enums, so that's the weakest operator that could split the code. Now I encourage you to open a reference to the JavaScript operator precedence table, linked below this video. Pause the video now and try to fill out the table on your own to check your understanding. In the next example, foo x modulus 10, the modulus operator is the only operator acting on x. Therefore, the strongest operator against x is order modulus. Although both the modulus and the member operators are contained in this block of code, the block of code could only split at the member operator since the modulus operator is contained within square brackets. Therefore, the weakest operator that could split the code is order member. For x and true, there are two operators acting on x, the logical not and the logical and operators. The logical not is the stronger operator, so the strongest operator against x is order logical not. The weakest operator that could split the block of code is order logical and. In the final example, the strongest operator against x and the weakest operator that could split the code are both order member. Now let's get into what can go wrong. If you're not choosing the right operator precedence, you're going to run into either too many parentheses or too little parentheses. These issues can be really tricky because there may only be too many parentheses or too little parentheses in very specific block combinations. Too many parentheses is less of an issue because the generated code is still valid. However, it may be hard to read with the extra parentheses, and it can sometimes hide issues with other blocks which might have an issue with order that cause it to not generate parentheses when it should. Too little parentheses is the bigger concern, because it can cause syntax errors in the generated code. Mistakes in order that cause extra parentheses are passing in a stronger than the strongest operator acting on the input, or returning a weaker than the weakest operator at which the return code could split at. This is why using order atomic for every value to code call and order none as a return for every value block will cause extra parentheses and also happen to generate valid code, although it is riddled with parentheses. Order atomic is the strongest operator, so it's guaranteed to be stronger than or equal to the actual strongest operator acting on the input. Order none is the weakest operator, so it's guaranteed to be weaker than or equal to the actual weakest operator that could split the code. As we reviewed our generated code, we've noted some similar mistakes in our repo, and we fixed them accordingly. We consider these mistakes in core to be especially bad because it makes it harder for contributors looking at our code base as a source of truth and how to correctly write generator code. Here I have some real-life examples of errors in JavaScript generation that were identified and are now fixed in core. The first issue I have here is for the multi-line text block, which returned string pre-wrapped in parentheses. You can see that the code generated for the print block with a multi-line input block had extra parentheses in the generated code. The multi-line block was always returning order atomic and pre-wrapping the code with parentheses when there was a string concatenation. To fix it, it was updated to return order addition when string concatenation was used, so that the output was only wrapped with parentheses when necessary. Looking at the text count block, you can see that there are extra parentheses in the generated code for the first parameter of text count. The value to code call in text count was passing in a stronger operator precedence, order member, when it should have been order none, because there are no operators acting on that input. In the last example, the code generator for the text count block was returning a weaker operator precedence, order subtraction, when it should have been returning order function call. This caused the code to be unnecessarily wrapped in extra parentheses. Mistakes in order that can cause not enough parentheses are passing in a weaker than the strongest operator acting on the input, or returning a stronger than the weakest operator at which the return code could split at. These are mistakes you want to avoid because they could cause the resulting code to evaluate incorrectly or cause syntax errors. Here I have an example of another, now fixed issue, where the incorrect order caused invalid code. The text multi-line block used a stronger operator precedence, order atomic, when it should have returned order additive, which prevented it from being wrapped in parentheses when passed as an input in the text count block. Some common mistakes and sources of mistakes are mixing up whether you're supposed to find the strongest or weakest operator. As a reminder, you want to return the strongest operator acting on the input for value to code calls, and the weakest operator that the code could split at for the return of value block generator code. Often people use the wrong order for parameters of a function call that have no operator acting on them. Order none should be used if there aren't any operators acting on the parameter, not order function call or order comma. The comma operator is a rarely used operator in JavaScript, and comma separating parameters in a function call are not instances of a comma operator. Order member and order function call is also often mixed up. Using the wrong one here shouldn't cause issues with code generation, but because you can't have both a function call and a member operator acting on the same X. However, it's best if you use the correct one because it makes it easier to understand the code. When writing generator code, use the most accurate operator precedence for min and max strength. Some complicated blocks may need additional logic to determine which operator precedence to use with value to code. TextGetSubString is a good example of a block that does some extra checks to determine which operator precedence to use. Although extra parentheses don't cause invalid code, they can hide issues with other blocks that might not be adding parentheses when they're supposed to, and your generated code will be harder to read. Another best practice is to not pre-wrap generated code in parentheses. Not only will this cause unavoidable extra parentheses, it can hide bugs in other blocks, making it hard to catch. Seeing parentheses in a return generator code can be a telltale sign of issues with operator order elsewhere. When we fix the multi-line text block to no longer return code pre-wrapped in parentheses and return the correct order, it revealed that there were issues in the order of other text blocks that then needed to be fixed. Thanks for watching this talk. If you have any questions, you can come to our Q&A session during our virtual summit. Or, if you're watching this after our virtual summit has concluded, you can post your question on our developer forum.